Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in today's video we are going to learn how to create application and service principle in Azure Active Directory. So let's understand what is application or service principle. Many times we required to access Azure resource from third-party tools like Vagrant or Docker Swarm to create VMs, VPC or any other Azure service. For that, you required a authentication and authorization on those Azure resources. Now question comes, what policy we should use for the authentication and authorization? Microsoft recommended to use application or service principle account to gain the access on Azure resources. For example, suppose that you want to control a VM on Azure environment with Vagrant, you require a combination of application and service principle to create VMs on Azure. So basically, before accessing the Azure resource, you required a combination of application ID, password, and tenant. You can understand the application ID has a user account on the Active Directory, and service principle has a service account who have the access on the resources. So I hope you understand what is the application ID and service principle, why do we require to create on Active Directory. In this demonstration we are going to use GUI as well as CMD to create application and service principle. A single default tenant is automatically creating for each Azure subscription or Visual Studio subscription. So this demonstration is targeting a single tenant. Currently I am connected with my Azure portal. Go ahead and search Azure Active Directory. First create or register the application ID. Go ahead and click on application registration. You can view all applications. If you select the all apps, these are application ID created. Many of the application ID from the Azure system, many of them created by me. So let's create a new one for this demonstration. Give the name of the application type, select the app and API and give the sign on URL. You can provide any valid URL. Go ahead and create it. So now you can see here application ID has been created. Now we required to assign the permissions or roles on this application ID. That is called service principle. So click on all services and click on subscriptions. Select the subscriptions. Now click on access control IAM. You can add a new role assignment or you can look at role assignment also. Click on views. These are app account and they have contributor role. Let's go ahead and click on add. Add role assignment. Select the role. I am providing the contributor, but you can decide any of the roles which you want to assign. Azure AD user group or service principal, and select the application ID. By default, it is not populating your application ID. You have to search manually. Go ahead and save it. Go ahead and refresh it. Now you can see our demo class application ID. At this moment, we have successfully created the application ID and assigned the contributor roles. Let's look at the requirement here. We required a application ID, we required a password, and we required a tenant. So go back to the Azure portal, go back to the Active Directory. In the Azure Active Directory, go to the application registration and get your application ID. So this is our demo class is application ID. So this is your application ID. Copy the application ID. Second one is display name. So this is the display name. Name you can use this default one. Next one is a password. To collect the password or key, click on settings and click on keys. Let's create a key. Select the duration and save it. Copy the key value. You won't be able to retrieve after you leave this blad. Copy this key. This is the password. And now last one is tenant. To get the tenant information, go to Azure Active Directory. Go ahead and click on properties. This is the tenant ID. Directory ID is a tenant ID, and this is the default directory or tenant for your subscription. This is the complete process by using GUI, but there is a smart and shortest way to generate all the information by the command line. Let's go ahead and generate the combination of application ID and service principal by the command line. Before generating the data from the command line, let's delete this application ID. It's done. To create a combination of application ID and service principal via the command line, you require to log in on Azure with Azure CLI. I'm connecting the Azure subscriptions. I am successfully connected my Azure subscriptions. Let's go ahead and create the application ID and service principal. This is the command. Okay, it has been created. This is the application ID. This is the name. And this is the tenant information. Let's verify the same information in Azure portal. This particular application ID has been created. This is the application ID. This is the display name, and this is the home page. These are system generated name and home page. Let's verify the service principal or roles. Go to all service, subscriptions, select your subscriptions. Go ahead and click on access control. View role assignments. Search by name. So now you can see here this application ID or account has a contributor roles. So you can use this service principal or application ID anywhere in your code or third party tools for the authentication and authorization on Azure resources to deal with Azure services. In this video, that's all. In the next video, we are going to create Linux and Windows VMs with the Vagrant by using these application ID and service principal details. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.